Before mid-20th century tourism opened up our globe's less trammeled regions, the natural beauty of Northern Ireland's County Fermanagh was known by few apart from those who lived, one way or another, off the land. Its feudal past was and is still very much in evidence. Castles, or later manor houses, still functioned as centers of community life. Castle Archdale was on one of Northern Ireland's largest inland bodies of water, Loch Earn. There had once been a castle. An English planter named John Archdale had built it in 1615, but it did not long survive. The Archdale stately home that soon replaced it had mainly the stress of upkeep over three centuries to account for its own eventual demolishment. Even so, despite its want of amenity by 1940, it had one overriding benefit for the Allied forces of World War II. It was situated to strategic advantage for the North Atlantic Ocean's defense. The way the countryside looks now, is that roughly what it would be?
Oh, yeah, this is what it was, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And I guess the weather was always changeable like this.
It was, yeah.
I found it fascinating that it was just a nice little dump of rain,
yeah.
And then 5 minutes later, bright
sunshine,
no clouds.
Oh, I know. There's one little dump, so I'll go back again to the top of the hill.
What is that?
Let me show you a wee minute.
Okay.
There's one glimpse over here.
Shall I leave the door open or close it? By 1940, bombings in Europe had reached the British Isles. Europe's North Atlantic lifeline was also under severe attack. Britain looked to Loch Earn for its center of air defense, and not a moment too soon was the Castle Archdale base established. Initial loss in aircraft and human lives was staggering. German U-boats were sinking vast numbers of supply ships with seeming impunity. A massive seaplane, the Sunderland, was key to hunting down and destroying enemy submarines.
Well, it had fairly long range and very pleasant to fly. Lots of room in it. And we had a good cook and good meals on board. And And that was important as far as I'm concerned, because the meals in the officer's mess were hardly fit to eat half the time.
When would this have been built?
This goes back to the 1700s.
And now, was there any more to this church than there is here? Because it doesn't seem to me there'd be very much room for...
Look at the grounds there. That's good enough for a small church and for a small population.
I guess so, yeah.
Just in the distance, I don't know if you can see that, but it'd be the Sligo Mountains. And we're looking at the Broad Loch, and that's where the Sunderlands and Catalinas flew out from Castle Archdale and got beat up, and then they took off for the following the River Erin and going out to the Atlantic. Sometimes when they're coming back in again, for example, that little banking area just across from us that we can see called Maho, that's where we've had some fatalities, young men coming in and just misinterpreted the information and they hit the top of the mountain and crashed. And there is a war grave over there, which obviously is treasured by everyone and respected. And the island then that we're turning around to look at is Creven Shahi. This is an old island going back to monastic times, and there's still the remains of a church on it. And as we go across then, we're looking at Castle Archdale, where all the trees are, and we've got some of the buildings of Castle Archdale. So during the war years, the Sunderlands would have been mirrored in the lee of these islands here to protect them from the weather. So when the guys came in again from their journey, they simply stopped. A boat would have come out to bring them back in again to Castle Archdale.
The Castle Archdale Air Base was essentially 8 squadrons patrolling the Atlantic. 2 of these were Canadian. Dad was commanding officer of 422 Squadron during his tour of duty from October 1943 to October 1944.
I normally did quite a bit of training of other pilots, so I didn't fly as much as the regular pilots. And I did trip every second week anyway, or maybe more.
At first, Dad took an active role in patrols, and hard upon taking command of Squadron 422, he navigated his Sunderland into position for a positive hit on enemy submarine U-610.
This was a little archway that during the war years, 2 guys were on guard duty. There was a guard room here,
yes.
And they took 2 little lime trees and they tied them together. And when Sid came back in the early 90s, he wondered, was it still here? And this was all overgrown. The guard room was here, and the boys on guard duty were bored. They just simply tied 2 little lime saplings together. And Sid knew about this. And when he came back, he wondered, was it still here? So this was all overgrown. The pathway, the roadway wasn't out as much. So we looked and we found it. So we put up a little stone in memory of Sid. Sid Irving, 422.
I guess he would still walk through it.
Yeah. else over here. It's just undergrowth there.
What village would this be?
Lisnarek, yeah, Lisnarek. And when your dad was here, this here was a public house here. Talana was a new building there, but there was a public house there.
So what else? There was the pub there, but what else would there be there?
That's all there was, really.
Oh, I see.
Pub and shop, yeah. We'll just come in here to show you this one.
Very picturesque.
It's nice, isn't it? It's great for walking here. Yeah. A lot of people walk.
So this is like a campsite these days?
No, this is just a forest amenity, yeah.
Oh.
A forest amenity, yeah.
Because I understood that there was a campsite now.
Yeah, there is, we'll be going to it. Yeah, there's the remains of the old castle.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
And I think this is a whitethorn tree.
Old Castle Archdale was built in 1615 by John Archdale. The estate, called Talana, was located just north of Lisnarek. The castle was seized during the Irish Rebellion of 1611 by Rory Maguire, who had formerly owned the land. The castle was returned to the Archdale heir, who repaired and lived in it until 1689. During the Williamite War, from 1688 to 91, the castle was burnt out and totally abandoned.
Now, this here, are these stones, there anything particular?
No, I just put them there. That's for putting the guns out, the muskets, as you can, you know, the guns.
Yeah. Yes, I wondered, because it it's certainly too small for a cannon, isn't it?
Yeah, the muskets, yeah.
And would there be any kind of glass in the windows?
Not at that stage, no.
No.
No, not at that stage. I see there's a sign saying this was restored in 2003.
Really?
Trying to use original material. That would be an old lime mortar.
Yes.
The original lime mortar, so the conservation work was done here.
Do we know where particular rooms were and...
There's just a basic plan over here. Yeah.
Now, I wonder how much of that would have been restored.
Yeah, well, you know what? Actually, you know, I'm coming out here from Youngster, and to me, it looks as if, looking at the left-hand side there, the wall there, you can see it, don't
you? Yes.
You can see that, and yeah.
It looks awfully...
Either side, doesn't it look as either side has been restored?
Yes, it does. Yeah. I mean, it's a little bit too hot, especially when you consider the...
But I suppose they did good work to find stones.
Yes.
And put them together, yeah.
I was in Hastings, the castle years and years ago.
Uh-huh.
And you have to use a lot of imagination there. This is so beautiful.
It's lovely.
Well, I was completely unaware that there really was a castle because...
Yeah, of course, because you focus on the other place all the time. I'm just looking, is the name still here in Latin? Yeah, it is here. Thank you, the other side. Yeah, here we go, up here. That's the Latin inscription. I'm going to go out this way through the grid.
Okay.
Get onto the path again. I'll just walk slowly down to the car. I'm in no hurry now, Norman. All
okay.
Right? I'm in no hurry, yeah. We'll go down, down here to the marina first of all, at the original site.
Ramp, does that mean
a bump? Up, yeah, and you have to slow
down.
Oh,
I see.
Yeah.
We just call them a speed bump.
Speed bump, yeah. This would have been the old operational building here. Park in here and then you can get out when you can walk here. Yeah.
So the lake is in that direction?
The lake is straight down here.
Down there.
When you look at the old photographs, this is where you saw the big hangars and so on.
Oh,
this
yes.
Area. And the cement that you're looking at is the original cement.
The cement here?
Yep.
Oh, really?
From the period, yeah.
Now, how would they get the Sunderlands in, inland?
And bring them into the water? Bring them in for surfacing?
Out, yes.
Yeah. I think there was lots of levers and so on.
Oh, I see.
It must have been an awful job.
I would think so.
When you think of it, bring them to the hangars, yeah.
Now, that looks as if people actually live here.
Yes, these are all privately owned.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now, how long was the base here before the war?
It wasn't here.
Nothing at all.
This is created. This was a virgin site, yeah.
From about 1939
yeah,
it started?
41, yeah.
Okay.
It was 41. Yeah, Christmas 1940, the lock was surveyed, and by February, this was operational.
When was the... was it a real fear that the British Isles were endangered?
1941, the convoys were being attacked coming from America and so on.
Oh, okay, yes.
And, something had been done to counteract the Germans. Just before you go any further, on the left-hand side, just down here, the building, stone building,
yes.
That was the original boathouse for the Archdales.
Oh.
Yeah, the road, and we've come right around. Yeah.
So we came around that...
See the house up there, across the bay?
Yes.
That's where we came down from.
Machine guns initially were 12-gauge, I think, but the nose gunner had 303, and we had just put on a heavier gauge. I've forgotten what it was, but we had that when we attacked the submarine. It was extremely beneficial because... the submarine was shooting at us, and all of a sudden their shooting stopped. And I think our nose gunner killed the gunner on the submarine. So that stopped the submarine firing. We flew right over the submarine before we sighted it at all. It was straight underneath the airplane. So I had to fly away from the submarine and turn around and come back so that our depth charges would be mobile then and both gunners would be in position to fire at the submarine. The captain, who was a young guy, he'd been down eating his steak and eggs. I was flying the airplane all the time that we were attacking the submarine, and I got to within about 15 seconds of attacking the submarine. He came up and he took over and flew the last 15 seconds of the trip. And so he sank the submarine, but he was so goddamn close to it that if he dropped the depth charges the normal way, he might have hit the submarine with one depth charge. But he dove on the submarine and dropped four at a crack. And all four of them hit the submarine and sank the sub. You drop four depth charges at a time. When I say at a time, just press one button and the depth charges will automatically space themselves. But he dove on them and they all went down straight on the submarine. So he did an exceptionally good job in that respect. He was so goddamn close, he couldn't do anything else and be sure of hitting it.
Even the weary routine of life far, far from home in the long year ahead could never quite eclipse this accomplishment high.
And we've wandered many a weary fit since auld lang syne. For auld lang syne, my jo, for auld lang syne, we'll tak' a cup o' kindness yet.
Cement there was also part of it. I'm wondering how they got that in there. Maybe I guess they maybe blocked it off.
They had
a bit.
To use sandbags.
Yes, sandbags. Yeah. Marina with no boats here.
Well, here are the boats over here. All
oh,
the boats,
I see.
Yeah, and all the boats are here. People would bring down boats. Among the things here, there was a Sunderland dock. It was supposed to be a repair dock. Sorry, a Shetland dock.
Yes.
And there's a couple of old artifacts there. If you want to go and take a look, it's,
yes.
It might be, you know, just to
love
see
to.
It anyway. Right. I'm not quite sure if I can, but we'll have to go this way just to see it.
Our way to the Shetland dock was unfortunately blocked. But here it is surviving nicely and evidently put to good use. We had one last stop.
Mm-hmm.